Hallelujah. And we talked a few causes. For those who have not been there, we said ignorance is one. When you don't know, you are not aware of God's working. Number two, we talked of deceitfulness of sin. When you know the truth and you fall in sin and you continue in sin, don't repent. Your heart becomes hard. The other one is fear. My wife, I think she has explained about fear. Fear, when fear comes, faith goes away. We talked of double-mindedness. You are wavering between two options. You have a plan B. You are praying to God, but you know what you want to do. That is unbelief. Walking by senses. You only believe when you see. Like we talked of this man called Thomas. Then we said pride. People who are proud do not believe God. They believe in their ability. They believe in their riches. And then we talked of impatience, where you cannot wait on God. Our believing is weakened, and slowly we turn away from God. And then the last one was believing wrong teachings. You know, when you have been taught wrong, and the true teachings come, you may not believe God. Hallelujah. Amen. Like teachings for you to be healed, you must give an offering. Jesus was tried for your hearing. Hallelujah. Amen. Wrong teachings have come. The Bible says, beware of false teachers because they will come. Hallelujah. When you are taught you must do another sacrifice, when Christ was the sacrifice once and for all, so you must be emptied. Wrong teaching to be put right ones. When you want to see the power of God and the effect of His power, you must get the light word. There are some teachings today which have made Christians weak. They cannot exercise authority. They cannot have power. Whereas God has given all that to them. Hallelujah. Amen. God has called us to reign with Christ. So I was today to start talking about the consequences. What happens when unbelief comes in? Hallelujah. But on Monday, God told me no. Before you speak about others, just first, He handed me two more causes of unbelief. So I'll begin with those two. Hallelujah. Amen. The ninth one. For those who have not been able to get the others, you can get my videos or my preaching. The other parts, you can get them on WhatsApp. You can get them on Facebook. So God told me, another cause that makes people to depart from believing Him and moving from faith, He said, is walking with mixed multitude. Mixed multitude means you walk with people who are unbelievers. You associate with them and fellowship with them. And you do all things with them as if you believe the same thing. I'm not saying you stay away from unbelievers. We have some even relatives who are not born again. But there's a sharing until they start influencing you. You start talking their language. Like this time we are living in. When people are talking of difficult times, life is becoming impossible. You begin to talk like them. Because you are yoked with them. Hallelujah. Let's go to Exodus. From verse 12, from verse 37. I want to cut a little bit so that I don't read all the scriptures. God brought the Israelites from Egypt with a mighty hand, as he has brought us to himself. Hallelujah. He has called us to a blessing. He has called us to an inheritance. That is what he did to the Israelites. And the Bible says the children of Israel journeyed from Ramesses to Succoth. Around 600,000 people, without counting the children. But the Bible says in verse 38, a mixed multitude went up also with them. Frogs, hands, and every much cattle. Amen. They left Egypt. God has come to deliver in Israelites, not Egyptians. But when they were leaving, they were joined by other people who are Egyptians. Hallelujah. And this brought them trouble because they never shared common belief. When you are with people you don't share the same belief, they will start drawing you away from what God has taught you. And you see the children of Israel, God is showing them signs and wonders. There was the crown that moves with them in the day. I call it the crown of glory. And there was a pillar of fire by night, which indicated the presence of God. Hallelujah. But as they walked with these people began to influence the Israelites. I still believe today, when they said, I wish we can go back to Egypt, where there were watermelons, where there was meat, I am tending to think the ones who began that story, the Egyptians who went with them, because they were used to that life. Because Israelites, they were slaves. And slaves never got very good things. Hallelujah. And so they started influencing Israelites against their gods. And as a result of this speaking, the Israelites began to become unbelievers. They started to question God. And reached a point where, when Moses went to be with God, and he seems to have tarried, they said to Aaron, make us a God we can see. Israel knew their God cannot be seen. But Egyptians had gods they can see. So they said, we want a God we can see. Moses has delayed. Make us a God who will take us to promised land. Hallelujah. Influence. Who do you work with? Because they will start introducing the gods they believe in. I've seen people brought out from the church by people who are unbelievers, by showing them, where is your God? You can see my God because you can see money. You can see what is happening around my life. But you have been talking of your God. You have been waiting on him. What do you have? Hallelujah. Yeah. And they are taken away. And they are taken somewhere to do something, to be done something by some diviners there. They are introduced to other gods. Hallelujah. Amen. They come to church. But there are other gods they are introduced to. And they began questioning what pastor preaches. They began saying that pastor is not anointed. Unbelief begins to set in. So the Bible says in Exodus 32, when Moses delayed, they came to Aaron and said, make us gods who shall go before us. For this Moses, the man that brought us out of the land of Egypt, we don't know what has become to him. Now, can see the language that is coming now. When unbelief begins to come in, our confessions change. They said, where is Moses, the one who brought us from Egypt? But you see, they were not brought from Egypt by Moses. They were brought by God. But now they are saying, man, Moses. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, they took out their gold earrings and gave them to Aaron, who fashioned for them a molten calf and said, this is thy God now. Yet the crowd is still there. Can you imagine? The fire in the night is still there. But they can have the audacity. They can have that confidence to make another God. When unbelief comes in, and they come slowly to people in the church, and they start questioning their faith. They say, why has God not answered my prayers? They were saying, why is Moses? In Psalm 106, verse 19, the Bible says they made a calf in Horeb and worshiped the molten image. I want you to note verse 20 of Psalm 106. Verse 20. They changed their glory, not God's glory. They changed their glory into the similitude of an ox that eateth grass. Amen. You know, you go with the glory of the God you worship. As far as they worship the true God, the glory of God was upon them. Hallelujah. But now they have made another God. And they have turned their glory to an ox that eateth grass. Can you imagine coming from the glory of God to the glory of a cow? Unbelief came in. That's what unbelief can do. Hallelujah. They are created in the image of God. But now they are saying their God is a cow. So they are saying our image is that of a cow. The Bible says in verse 21, they forgot their Savior, which had done great things in Egypt. When we begin to move away from God, slowly you begin to forget what God has done for you. I saw people, God has done miracles. But I came to talk against that same God afterwards. Hallelujah. This is what happens when you love the company of our association of unbelievers. Amen. You cannot stay away from them. Even where you work, even at home. But you have been called to witness Christ to them. Not to join them in their life. Not to join them in their wilderness. Hallelujah. You don't become to fellowship with them. Because they will start telling you, take me somewhere. You will start behaving like them. Bring them to church. Witness Christ to them. Glory to God. Some people, you know, you become match with them. Your character changes with the people you associate with. If you walk with people who fear God, you become a person who fears God. When you walk with the wise, you become wise. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Amen.
But if you walk with people of bad morals, however much you are saved, they will corrupt your character. Glory to God.
Amen.
You know, I sat somewhere one time with a woman who used to complain so much. She was a working colleague. That person would complain about everything. And soon I found myself to begin complaining. Until one day I asked myself, what am I complaining about? Because I did not know that I'm complaining. When you begin to change, unless you are careful, you not know you're changing. But the people around you, they will start seeing you are changing. Even believing is the same. When you unbelief start coming in, we said unbelief is when you are no longer persuaded by the word of God. When you no longer have confidence in what God has spoken, when you now start, you stop believing God for what you want Him to be done. And it comes slowly. And it comes slowly. So when you become yoked with unbelievers, hallelujah, they began to introduce us to their gods. They start influencing us to gods of pleasure. Allow me to say this. There's a move that came was called Kamweredo. And people loved it. And I don't know, even Christians began to do it without knowing the basis of it. You know, it's good to know the basis of something. I know it from the scripture. What's the basis? And so, some Christians had shipwreck. They had problems. Because these people had their own ideas. You know, I heard of a story where they went to a certain county. I did not know in that Kamwere though, there are men who are wamepangana. They have arranged with other men, women with other men. So some married women, they asked for permission from their husbands to take so and so to their parents for blessing. And the husbands also tells their wives, we are taking so and so. So the husband has left the wife, and the wife has left the husband. So they go. So on coming back, I had a very interesting story. Because there are some people who are born again in that group also. So they told the driver to pretend that the vehicle has a mechanical problem. Oh my God. And so they could not, because it was far, they could not come back. So they went to hotel and said, let's stay here as we wait for the vehicle to be repaired. And when they are there, they say, take a drink, take a drink. And they are pairing up people. They are pairing up people. In the process, even those who are born again find themselves drinking. I'm not talking about water, I'm talking about alcohol. And then they were told, this vehicle cannot be repaired today until tomorrow is when we shall go. Do you know why it was being done? The agenda was worldly pleasure. And some people fell into the wrong hands that night. Why? They went with mixed multitude. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It's good to understand these things. That's what the Bible is warning us in 2 Corinthians 6:14. Do not be unequally yoked with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with unrighteousness? What communion has the light with the darkness? There's somebody will tell you. Why do you have to pay your license for business? I say, we don't pay the county council for business. When they come, we run away, we close our shops. And you find yourself and you are born again, begin to do so. What you are doing, you are opening a door. Hallelujah. And you find yourself suffering. Because the enemy has been looking at how he can get you. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to talk about God, something God was speaking to me. About today. Because he said, believing begins with the mind. So the presence you visit, the things you see and you hear influence your believing. You cannot go to convert people in the bar. They will change you instead. Hallelujah. Amen. That is their territory. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today, God was speaking to me that many believers are foreign. Their faith is dying. And especially at these difficult times. Because what they have been called contemporary Christianity, modern Christianity. Modern Christianity is what I mean, a mixture of ordinariness and Christianity. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So there are things that are no longer seen now. There are things seen, Dambi. There are things people are embracing. They are now taking which were there before bad things. People have begun to claim that Christianity has to evolve. We are in changing times. So how we believe God should also change. Hallelujah. And you find, now they are saying you can even embrace some things which are wrong. And allow them, even in church. Hallelujah. Like things like unnatural sexual relationships. I'm saying unnatural. You marry the wrong way. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Amen.
You marry people who are not supposed to be married. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because it's not even natural. Even animals do not do that. They don't go man for man or woman for woman. These days, I found Christians listening to secular music. And they are enjoying them. They are saying they are talking about our culture. Glory to God.
Amen.
But what is it adding to them? Glory to God.
Amen.
Ungodly relationships. And they are saying, it's okay. Things have changed. Things have changed. And when you join these people, what happens is that you get weird out your believing. There's a claim for traditional practices to be included in the worship. Practices and rituals which even goes against Christian belief. You are told you must come and bring a sacrifice. And I want to tell us people as Africans. I want to tell Africans like me. And Kenyans like me. You cannot be in God, in Christianity and in traditions. There are sacrifices you are not supposed to do. Because Christ became a sacrifice once and for all. There are many people who are suffering today because they opened a door by setting in some traditional sacrifices. They were told, this thing for it to go, you must do some sacrifices. And you went ahead to make a sacrifice of goats. But it has not changed. Instead, you have been moved from God. Because you must keep on sacrificing. And your life is not changing. And you are born again. Where is the power of the blood of Jesus? Hallelujah.
Amen.
You laugh me for telling you this. You laugh me. You know, if I step on your toes, please. Because I want you to be delivered from that has been troubling you. Hallelujah. I'm talking about mixed multitudes. They bring teachings and false ideas. But listen what I want to tell you today. God has not changed. And the Bible does not change. It changes things. It has taken the beginning and the end of time. It is the most modern book. Hallelujah. It never grows old. The word of God is settled in heaven. And it cannot be changed. So also Christ. The Bible says in Hebrews 13:8, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He has not changed the way he heals people. He has not changed how he saves people. There is no other way he has created. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And he's not going to change. Hallelujah. The other things coming in are men's ideas. And that's why there's no power today. You go to church and you find there's no power. That is not the church of Jesus Christ. The church of Jesus says there's power to heal. There is a power to set free people. When you receive Christ, you get born again and your life changes. That's what the Bible says in Colossians 2:8. I'll read from his English. It says, some people may try to teach you false ideas. Be careful that you don't believe them. Those ideas may seem clever and good, but they will take you away from God. Those ideas are the result of things that people have taught for many years. But those ideas belong to this world. They don't come from Christ. That's why God is encouraging us. Hallelujah. In Hebrews 10:25, stay in the fellowship of believers. Stay close. They will encourage you to walk in the faith. You will pray together. When you are going through difficult times, they will tell you the Lord is coming. Hey, God is able to do it. Hallelujah. Amen. It's saying in verse 25 of Hebrews 10, not forsaking the assembling together of brethren, much so much more you see the day approaching. Amen. I want to speak on that one. I've taken a lot of time. I want to speak about the second one. What is believing is called unbelief. I mean offenses. Offenses, belief, being unbelief. Offenses, being unbelief. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Amen.
Offenses. And I think we can stop there.
Amen.
Just a minute.